Okay, let me make sure I'm online. Okay, hello, I'm Alex from AP Ink. So, kind of picking up where I left off yesterday, I was playing with watercolor pencils. The brand I am using is Mongol. I hope I'm saying that right. Anyways, so yesterday I did kind of two techniques, I guess. I would consider this maybe like a dry technique, and I guess like wet. So dry being I colored the paper and then added water. This one I actually direct from the pencil with a wet brush. I took the pigment right from the pencil, so the colors are a lot more vibrant. Neither one of these ended up being anything close to what I was trying to go for. I think both techniques have their place, but just the overall composition is wrong. This is the reference that I'm going for, or that I'm using anyway. So I want to try and create something that actually looks like clouds. I had just looked up storm clouds, and I found this on the internet, but I thought the composition was cool. You've got some kind of light sky peeking out here, the light source is here, dark clouds through the center that have different color play throughout. But I'm gonna try this again. I think I'm going to try to combine these two techniques. So maybe like a dry technique for the light areas here, and then the wet technique for the clouds. I want to see how that will work. Okay, so I've got watercolor paper. I'll try to keep this so you guys can see the reference. So I think I'm going to try this one landscape instead of portrait. So I'm going to start with the light section here and here. This is lemon yellow. I hope this isn't boring for anybody. I'm sure there's all kinds of people who are more practiced with watercolor and or watercolor pencil. I'm not. But if nothing else, you can either use this as just a hangout, or if you're also learning, maybe you can learn with me. I don't know if that really needed to be said, but there it is. Okay, just for transition, I think because when I did this yesterday with the yellow to the orange, I was hoping it would blend at all, and it kind of didn't. The colors just kind of sat where I put them. So that was yellow, and this was, I think, light orange. So if I do a transition color, that was lemon yellow that I started with. This is yellow. So I'm going to use the yellow between the lemon yellow and the light orange. So light orange. So I'm just working on this area here. I don't know. Forgot to turn my ring light on. Don't know if that actually makes a difference or not. Having the ring light on. I don't know, it seemed like in some of the playbacks, you can see it better at an angle. Okay. It starts pulling in purple just here. So I'm gonna have to do that too. But where I should transition from dry to wet. Obviously in the clouds. I'm thinking. Well, I suppose right there. Okay, so I've got scarlet. Purple. I'm hoping you can actually see that and the ring light isn't blinding you. Apologies, I had the mat on the wrong side. This is lemon yellow. I don't know, maybe I should have gone with white instead. I probably should have. Just for this bit here. think I'm gonna try and correct this. What I might end up doing is filling the whole space with the purple and then coming back in with white directly from the pencil to the brush. To actually try and recreate this kind of misty cloud area. Trying to hold the picture so you can see without the ring light. Okay, I think I'm gonna switch off to this upper corner here. So here, well, I'll transition this a little bit more. I think I'm going over too far, though. So I've got dark blue and light blue. Okay, so I'm not going to go too crazy with the dark blue because I think for the rest of this, it's going to be that wet technique that I said at the beginning of this. But even the light blue might be too dark. Might have to add some white. I'm kind of curious how that is would work. If it would really lighten the blue when I add white water to it. I might not use the dark blue here. I was just gonna use the dark blue just a bit for down in this area where the blue of the sky is a bit darker. Whoop. But I might just use the white to lighten and see if that actually translates when I add water. Which I don't know if it would make more of an impact if I used it wet brush. I don't know if there is actually a name for the techniques I'm talking about. Excuse me. I will be right back. Okay. I think from there, I'm gonna fill in this bit like I said, with that wet technique. So I've got water, a brush, ink. I'll start with light blue. I do have a paper towel. Somehow, I gotta figure out how to feather the edge between the sky and the cloud. Okay, so I've got a dark blue. Actually, I think I should have added light blue because there is like a ridge right here where there's more light. I'm gonna try and hold off on touching the, I guess, dry parts until after I finish the cloud. Excuse me. I'm not sick, I just have allergies, in case you're new here. I am fully aware how gross I probably sound. I might have to sharpen this. Not sure how well it's gonna work out wet. Because I've never sharpened a wet pencil before. Okay, I do have a pencil sharpener right here, but I'm gonna use an X-Acto knife to sharpen this. Only because I was having such a hard time sharpening these. And I'm not sure how far down it's split under the paint. Under the paint of the pencil. Okay, so not a whole lot, but just enough to expose more of the pencil. Okay, so I need to transition to red at some point here. I'm not sure how muddy this is going to end up getting. I don't think I'm quite getting there for the tones in the cloud. So this is scarlet. I might be wrong. The color play over the light part of the clouds here. I was thinking it was red or a red tone, but maybe it's actually orange. Okay. I'm kind of nervous to dirty the white, but I want to see if I can't add a little bit more some of the lighter tones here. Don't know. Well, that, and I really have to darken up some of these areas. Mean, there already is some feathering here. I don't know why I thought that was black yesterday. Yesterday I thought the distance here actually transitioned to black, but it doesn't. I'm kind of thinking this one is not going to come out looking like clouds either. So I'll probably have to try again. So I'm gonna get into the dry parts here and see how they kind of blend together. But also to try and weaken some of the harsh line between the wet and the dry. I mean, there should be some kind of separation because you can see that here too. Between the cloud and the sky, there is kind of a line. Maybe not as harsh as I have here. I'm curious how much the white is going to play against the purple here. Purple is, even with as pastel as it is, purple is still a much stronger color than white. I think I might have to pull in some from the pencil to darken this up a bit because it is so dark just here. Okay, so this is purple. think I went too dark here. If you remember, I did hit this curve here with quite a bit of white. If it is playing any kind of effect, I'm not sure it's really noticeable. I really don't want to do this, but I just want to see what adding the white will do. I just want to make sure my brush is clean, so I don't tint the white. Even with how light this white is, or blue is, I don't think you can really see. I think it's still overpowering. Although I may have been able to hit, kind of create the same effect had I just added more white, water, to try and wash out this guy right here. Okay, so I'm gonna think just here try and soften the transition. But maybe also try and catch that almost white line where the sun hits the ridge of the cloud. Okay. Don't really think that. Again, I'm I wasn't necessarily going to copy it, but I kind of did. And I think that's just a matter of trying to get the colored pencils to do kind of what I want. Hopefully you can see that. Obviously, it's not exact. I don't know. I think I'm gonna leave this stream here. Let this dry. See exactly what it looks like dry. I might have to, for one, I wanted to see exactly what I could do with these colored pencils. Try and get anything that looked like clouds. I might have to go a different way. Anyways, that's something I'm gonna have to try and figure out. I am gonna leave this stream here. Thank you to anybody who watched or watches after the fact. I do plan on being back tomorrow about 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time for anybody who would like to join me. If you would like to join me, please make sure that you're following me and that your notifications are turned on so that you're notified for when I do go live. Other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye.